Ratna Devi, it's lovely to be able to introduce Ratna Devi. I know Ratna Devi a little bit. We're both from the Glasgow Sangha, latterly. She has been ordained since 1982. So some of you may know her, I don't know, but she's a qualified coach, mindfulness teacher and trainer, and author. And she leads work that reconnects work, and other types of retreats and workshops, and supports activists through online mindfulness sessions. She's also got an allotment, keeps an allotment, and she's a visual artist, and I've been to her exhibitions. I can vouch for it. In fact, I've got one little piece of hers on my wall, so yeah, it's nice to connect that way. So, and she recently brought out a book called Bringing Mindfulness to Life, which some of you may know. And we'll be putting links in the chat at some point. So just to say that you can join by the interpreting button. She should be able to see if you want the German channel. I'm sure you'll have worked out that by now if you were requiring that. So I think it just remains for me to hand over to Ratna Devi, and she'll say a little bit more about what she's going to do.
Thank you very much, Angela. And I'm really delighted to see so many people here this morning. Yeah, really wonderful. And it is particularly with the subject matter we are concerned with, you know, the state of the world and climate change and so on. It can sometimes feel so daunting to be alone with it. And, you know, just being in a sangha together to explore these things and feel the companionship, it just makes such a difference. It makes all the difference, really. So thank you very much, everybody, for showing up this morning. And so you have already presumably read a little bit about this meditation I'm going to lead you in. So I don't want to say too much about it, but just kind of go into it. We don't have that much time. But just maybe say that it really is about our feelings for the world, you know, which sometimes can seem quite daunting and have a whole range as well, you know, from maybe feeling sometimes a bit despairing or angry or numb. And there's actually a gift in these feelings. That's what I feel. When we can open to them, explore them, befriend them, there's a lot of energy there that can then be used for action. And it may be in sometimes surprising ways if we just sort of enter into a bit of a process with them, just trust that process. I was just wondering, actually, to start with, if we just all just think a little bit about what the issues are that really concern us, that most concern us at the moment. And if you would just put that in the chat, into the chat as a chat message, just a word even, you know, just what is it? Climate change? Is it species loss? Is it immigration? What is it? Is it the war? You know, you just get a little bit of a collective sense of what concerns us. And I can just read that out as a little list, just to help us all to connect with it. Would that be okay? You just put in just one word about something that concerns us in the world. Loss of biodiversity. It seems dignity and compassion are lost in the world, hatred, climate, crisis, polarization and right-wing populism, Erderwärmung, war, heat and water, war. Yeah, that comes up again and again. That's really uppermost, isn't it? Forced migration, extreme weather events, runaway climate. Yes. Thank you very much. So we can maybe just thank you very much for those who have just written something. So let's just take a moment now to get settled in our posture. You know, you may want to just change a little bit how you're sitting, so you're a little bit more upright, maybe, you know, do a few stretches. How the body can feel good and ready for this meditation just now. And if it feels right, you may want to close your eyes. And come into your body, letting the weight of the body be received by the earth. Maybe considering that everybody who is in this call is part of the same earth, rooted into the same earth, and feeling our connection and togetherness. It can really help to spend a bit of time coming into the body quite fully. Sensing the feet, temperature of the feet, what they're in touch with, maybe socks, footwear. And also the seat where we are having the contact with our cushions or our chair. Just feeling the weight of the body bearing down. And maybe quite naturally, you also experience the breath. Maybe being able to let go of some layers of tension with the exhalations. And feel the freshness and spaciousness that comes with the inhalations. The breath of life. Being present, opening, softening, receiving the stream of life flowing through us. Being open and welcoming to the whole range of experiences that might be present. Sensations, feelings, thoughts, images. Everything is welcome. Now, a good starting point for this kind of meditation is to connect with positivity in us. And one very easy way is to be grateful, to just bring to mind something we feel gratitude for right now. It might be just the fact that we are here together, this wonderful opportunity to meditate together. Or something else that fills your heart with gratitude. And really noticing what that is like. Maybe some opening, some warmth, a little brightening of the spirit. Or maybe it's difficult for you just right now to contact those emotions, and that's absolutely fine. We stay with our experience as it is. If there is a sense of connection with each other, with the Sangha, then allowing ourselves to feel the support of that. Something much bigger than just our small self that is involved in this meditation. It's almost a sense of breathing together with everyone here. Now, if it feels right, we bring to mind one of these areas that we are concerned about and that you would like to explore in this meditation, your feelings about it. So just choose something that just feels right, not too heavy, you know, just in a way we're just kind of learning about this process. So something of medium intensity. So it could be food security, displacement, political stability, floods, wildfires, poverty, you know, some of the things we have put into the chat. What comes into your mind? And take a few moments to just let that unfold. In your mind, maybe some images come up, maybe some thoughts about it, maybe some details of what's involved in this issue. So just let it take shape in your awareness. And together with those images and thoughts, some feelings are likely to rise to the surface. I just notice if there's some openness there in you to meet them. Or maybe there's some resistance there, and that's, you can just make friends with that resistance that has got its purpose. What are the feelings? We're just now starting to enter into this second stage of the meditation of allowing them, just befriending them, just inviting them to be seen, because that's what they want. They want to be acknowledged, they want to be seen, they want to be heard. Or it could be fear, sadness, outrage, helplessness, despondency, anger. or maybe shame for just being somehow complicit. And paying attention to how it manifests in your body. So really getting to know these feelings, becoming intimate with them. Just exploring them as felt sensations or energetic states in your body. And breathe with these feelings. Just be there right alongside them. Maybe some tension in the jaws, heaviness in the heart, general flatness or agitation, clenching in the stomach. Because all that is very common as well. We are not alone with this. These are shared human experiences. Just for now, we don't need to think about what we could do, what needs to be done, if there is anybody to blame for it. Nothing of that. If we can just let that go, if it arises, and really just stay with the feelings. It's a gift we're giving ourselves here. Breathing with the feelings. Now we're starting to become curious and investigate what needs are connected with these feelings. For example, if our main feeling is anger, we probably have a need for fairness and justice. Or if it is helplessness, you may want a sense of agency or to be heard. If it is sadness, you may have a need to mourn. Or numbness points to a longing for aliveness. Or fear, it's a need for safety. So, you know, right within the feeling is a cue as to what we're actually longing for, what's important to us. And see if we can actually connect with that quality. And then we are starting to open ourselves more fully to that quality, what it feels like. So say if it is safety, we just have what that does feel like to be feel safe right now in our bodies. And let ourselves be nourished by that. Again, using the breath to let it percolate through the whole body. Letting it unfold in our experience, that very quality we are longing for. It might be that some related qualities suggest themselves as well. Maybe after a while you just kind of feel, well, this is really what matters. Maybe it's justice or a sense of agency of being able to do something or something. But what is it that really comes into your experience now? What really matters? Living, let that quality live in you, unfold its beauty. Now we come to the next step, which is to see if there's an image that would encapsulate that very quality. What does safety look like? What sort of metaphor might come for it? And it could be in the shape of a person, a landscape, or a symbol. What is the shape or the sound of, say, peace or justice or safety or whatever it is you are in touch with? Is it like a mountain? Is it like a Buddha or Bodhisattva? Like a lake? Like colored light? And so if you're staying now with this metaphor, with this image, and we imagine what the world could look like if this quality would spread through the whole world, if it would affect the situation you were initially thinking about, and you know, all beings in the world and the planet itself would be affected by it. So the power of this metaphor just spreads and opens up possibilities. Like a blessing that can spread from this image. We may have a sense of how the world can be transformed, could be really quite different. And now is the last stage, no limits, from the perspective from, you know, like this is going forth, considering what might be a small, doable next step for us. You know, what a little part we can play in this unfolding. One little drop in the big ocean of this transformation that is made up of small drops. That's all it is. Some little thing you may be able to do, and if nothing comes, that's absolutely fine. You may want to just stay with your experience as it is, not forcing it. Maybe a little idea ripples up. And now I'm going to read a little extract from the White Lotus Sutra, the parable of the Dharma as a rain cloud, to move towards the end of this meditation. The rain falls everywhere, coming down on all four sides. Its flow and saturation are measureless, reaching to every area of the earth, to the ravines and valleys of the mountains and streams, to the remote and secluded places where grow plants, bushes, medicinal herbs, trees large and small, 100 grains, rice seedlings, sugar cane, grapevines. The rain moistens them all, none fails to receive its full share. Now we just sit quietly, absorbing the effects of this meditation, nothing to do. And then we just gradually starting to bring our awareness into all the senses, including opening our eyes, sounds around us. Maybe just be connecting with everybody on the screen. So I would be really grateful if some of you might want to share something of your experience of this meditation, maybe in the chat, or you could just speak out loud, just anything that that moved you in the meditation, and or any questions.
And I'm buzzed. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Thanks a lot, Radhanadevi. I'm gratefulness is really dwelling up in me. I'm really touched. You really, I feel really taken away and reconnected and quite a mixture of feelings, really. But it was really beautiful and also that last image with the rain. I think it's going to change my view on that wet element for the next time. So yeah, really, thank you.
Thank you so much, Stefan. I'm really touched hearing you talk. Wenn jemand aus Deutschland sprechen möchte, ich kann euch sogar verstehen. Yeah, if somebody from Germany wants to speak. Okay, just give it just a little bit longer, just in case somebody wants to say something. There's no pressure, of course. Helen.
Yes, yeah, sorry, just so sorry I was late. I had problems accessing the Zoom link. Yeah, it was just a really lovely process, a really, really helpful process to just... yeah, to just really dive into what are often such difficult feelings and to just make friends with them. I just really appreciated that direction, to make friends with those feelings, as well as to think about embodying the needs underneath those. So just really appreciated that. Thanks very much, Ratnadevi.
You're very welcome. I can screen share the sort of stages of this, if you like. I'll just do that now. Let's see where it is. I think it's here. No, that's not it. Yeah, it looks like I have. The technology. Okay, here we go. No, it's still the wrong one. Oh. Screen. Yeah. There we are. So it's like an acronym. Raining. The R is for recognize the issue. allow the emotions that are alive in you. And the I is for investigate, related to your feelings, what needs are not met. Then the N is the nourishing, experiencing the fullness of the need or qualities you're longing for. Then the imagine from deep within you, you just let a metaphor arise. And then no limits from the perspective of this metaphor, what could the world look like? And then the going force, what is a small doable step? So reining, it takes it, you're probably familiar, some of you may be, Tara Brach's rein meditation. So that's a starting point and taking it into action. And I can also put these links. So there is a write-up of this meditation that you could connect with. And there is also a YouTube meditation similar to the one I just led you through. So I'm just going to copy this one and put that in the technology is what was a bit challenging. Okay, I'm just going to copy the whole thing. So I just put that in the chat if some of you might want to copy that and keep it safe for your own use later on. So are there any other questions? I know we don't have very much time, and Angela wants to say something before we have to finish, but there is definitely time for one or two comments or questions before we do that. Dianita.
Hello. I just want to say another thank you. I got here late as well, and I got in really flustered because same thing, I couldn't find a link, but I feel really settled now. I just echo what Stefan said. I really loved the reading on the rain and the sort of letting my difficult feelings be. So yeah, I just want to say another thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for being here. Okay, over to Angela.
Thank you, Ratna Devi. And I was obviously just keeping an eye on the waiting room and that kind of thing, but I heard little bits of that. It was really lovely. And I remember doing it before with you in the Glasgow Social Action Killer. Thank you. So yeah, I hope you're all feeling the benefit of that. It's lovely to hear from people. So before we go, I'm very aware that many of you will have contributed something as by way of, monetary support when you registered. Maybe you didn't. And if you're not thinking about doing anything else or, giving at all, that's absolutely fine. But if you did feel moved to give something to anything that's given to it, sort of gets split between BCO and Tuvatna Earth Sangha. So it just helps both organisations continue to do what they do. And we do rely on, certainly Tuvatna Earth Sangha relies on just really what we get from these events. And it would be wonderful if in future somebody, for example Shantikarpa, maybe might be able to do some supported work for this organization. He does do a lot, and we're not at that point yet, but if anybody does feel moved to give, I'll put a link in the chat just now. And just thanks for listening. If you want to say anything to finish up, Rana Devi, I don't know.
Well, I'm just sort of curious, really, about what people, you know, like why you're here and what draws you to be part of this conference, and, you know, just to have a little bit more of a sense of who we are, really. We have got just another 6 minutes, I think, before we're finishing. So it's really just an opportunity for sharing. Or even if there's something that arose from this meditation that, you know, maybe an image or, you know, a next step that you saw, some possibilities opening up. Yeah, it'd be really just lovely to hear a little bit more. Joy.
I'd just like to say I'm here because I often feel a great hopelessness or helplessness. And I found it so helpful to just be part of a larger group of people who are also feeling, maybe not those things, but also feeling. Well, just to be able to share what we're all feeling about situation in the world. And so, yeah, I just wanted to be here to share and to be with others. And that helps me to feel less helpless as well.
So. Yeah. Who else feels that way? Yeah. Thanks for putting that into words. And Karuna Vaja.
Yeah, I think for me, you know, I've kind of been involved in activism about climate, you know, mainly through Extinction Rebellion for quite a lot of years. And at the same time, I'm very involved in my Sangha, my local Sangha, and the order. And sometimes I just find myself feeling very split and sometimes a little bit alone in those situations. And sometimes, you know, some unhelpful feelings come up in me of, you know, some frustrations or whatever. And so it's very beautiful to, you know, any opportunity to kind of, that helps me kind of bring those things together more in and connect with people. Within the Sangha around these issues just feels very helpful for me. And I love the meditation. It just really opened me up and sort of brought it together in me in as much as, you know, some of what came out of it for me was just about being very present in the moment, you know, which is very connecting of those things for me, if you see what I mean.
Yes.
Right. I thought it was beautifully led as well. Thank you, Retna Devi. It was so, yeah, that's me really.
Hannah.
Yeah, so I'm Helen, I'm in the Newcastle Sangha, and I'm just like the previous speaker, it's just great to connect with other people who feel some of the urgency, I suppose. We have a smaller Sangha in the Newcastle Sangha, which isn't a big centre. And it's just very heartening to be able to talk about the meta crises and the climate emergency with fellow Buddhists. And so I've been coming to these conferences since they started, and it's just a really great place to think about all the tools we have in Buddhism that can help us manage and to be inspired to show up in whatever ways we can, really, for our sanghas and our communities.
Yeah. Thank you, Helen. And I think, Hannah, you were putting your hand up. Do you want to unmute yourself?
Yes. I feel really grateful to be here. I was originally going to go on a small weekend trip, but fell ill, or I have a sore throat, so I needed to stay at home. And I'm really grateful for that now, so I could be here and participate. And I think one of the reasons that I so much value this particular space is that I can put my practice into action, in a sense. And during the meditation, a lot of image came up, and I was thinking about my hometown. I from the countryside in Sweden, and I was thinking about the forest that's all around, but it's not a forest. It's more of a field of trees. It's not a forest. It's the same type of tree planted the same year, as for as long as your eyes can see. And it took me until I was about 20 until I felt like I was in an actual forest. And I feel really sad about that. And when I explored that, I realized, like, I was following this stream of sadness, and I was like, oh, it comes from a well of compassion. Like, I just love the forest. I want all the little creatures and mushrooms and trees and rotten bark to be there. I love it a lot. I love it so much, and I wanted to also be in this world.
Beautiful, Hannah. I just really get, I can almost smell the real forest, you know, the fungus and everything.
So thank you.
Okay, so I think we need to finish. It's important to keep the time boundaries, and I just want to say just once more just what a pleasure it was to be with you this morning. Thank you, everybody, for coming and just being here. It is action. It is actually an expression of our love for the world. Yeah. Go well, and I see you maybe in some of the other events today.
Thanks, Ratna Devi. Thank you very much to Nyana Chandra.
Thank you. Goodbye.